Number eight. (laughs) 1.1x, does that sound right?
Yeah.
Plus 1.2x, I forgot about this, no I didn't. 1.2x minus 5.4 equals negative 10. Right? So this is where we've added a little bit of a twist here, just a little bit of a one, because to start this equation, what would you recommend doing first?
Adding.
Brandon?
Never mind.
Robert?
Add 1.1x plus 1.2x.
Combine those x's, right? We've never had that before this section, right? So we combine like terms first. We get 2.3x minus 5.4 equals negative 10. Robert?
Now you add a positive 5.4 to each side of the equal sign.
Why would I add 5.4 to this side?
To cancel the 5.4 to get x by itself.
All right, so we get the x term by itself, and on this side we get negative 10 plus 5.4 is negative. Oh, it's a negative 10 plus 5.4.
No. It's negative 4.4.
4.6.
Yeah, 6, right?
Yeah, 4.6.
Yeah, 6. You got confirmation on that? Okay, well I'm going to move on. You confirm. Make sure that we don't make a mistake here. I'll have to go back and fix it. So now we would, what?
Divide 2.3
on both sides. I like when you say on both sides, because sometimes people say divide negative 4.6 by
2.3.
2.3x. Do all of it.
It would be 1x.
1x equals... Now we got a calculator girl over here.
Negative.
Divide for us.
Sorry,
1.6.
Turn on. Oh, 20.
It hasn't worked.
Negative 2.
Oh, yes.
I got negative 2. Negative 2,
I promise. I did it in my head.
What if you
promise?
Me too.
Oh, yeah.
Don't lose it. You're losing your minds
negative
here.
Two.
Shh. All right. We're recovering. Good recovery. Okay, number what?
11.
11. Times.
It's the number.
Minus x.
You mean 11?
Plus 12. Well, this is the problem. I didn't write down the number. Equals 44. So this is number 11. Vacated. All right, what would you do first here? A little bit of a twist, Robert.
You would do 21 times 2 and do that.
42.
And then you would do 21 times x, which would be, there's an invisible 1 by the x, so it's 21x.
21x.
It's negative, right? Negative 21x. What did Robert just do? What's that called?
Distribute.
You distributed the 21. That's great. 12x equals 44. Now what? Kaden?
You, negative 21x plus 12x.
Very good. Which would give us negative 9x. 42, 44, okay.
I know it was right.
Emma?
You subtract 42 from both sides.
Subtract 42, negative 9x equals 2.
And then?
Aubrey?
Follow
your heart.
What
does your heart tell you? Right here, what would you do to get x by itself?
You would add 9.
Not quite. Because if we would, if it was x minus 9, then we would add 9. But it's negative 9 times x, so how do we cancel out that multiplying by negative 9? Divide by negative 9. X equals negative 2/9. And we're not afraid of fractions, so we'll just leave it just like that, instead of writing negative 0.2 repeating. Robert?
So if you're confused if you simplify or not, can you do both answers in decimal and fraction?
Decimals are not simpler. So I would call that simplifying, just be writing it as a decimal. Unless I ask you to write it as a decimal, I love fractions. So if you just leave it as a fraction, that would be great.
That confused the decimal.
Okay, that was 11, now 15?
Yep.
15. Let's see. Got this postcard, see? Okay, so we got this postcard. It's split into two parts. This part is for your address and a stamp. And over here is where you write all your salutations and stuff. Okay, on this side it's four. Excuse me. This from here to there is 3 inches. And from here to there is, we don't know. We don't know how long that is. What they do tell us about it is that the area of the postcard is 24 square inches. What is the width of the, oh, it says B. It says we call it X, it calls it B, whatever. It's an unknown. Okay, so the area is 24. So the first part is to write an equation for the area that enables us to solve for B. Well, to find the area of a rectangle is my first question. How do you find the area of a rectangle part?
With by height,
right? And so we could call this the height. We could write an H. All right, and we could call this the width, right? Height is the width, because that's a formula?
Yes.
No. Is it the formula? Yeah, if you go out in the world and you ask people what's the formula for the area of a rectangle, they'll tell you that, but it's because height times width helps us count what, how many what fit.
How many cubes?
Squares.
Squares.
Cubes are three-dimensional, squares are two-dimensional, areas two-dimensional. Okay, so the height is something, the width is something, and Sienna's going to help us with that.
Okay, so the equation finding out the other side of the width would be b plus 3 times 4 equals 24, and we put b plus 3 in parentheses.
That's pretty important, right?
Yeah.
Very important thing. So b plus 3 in its entirety makes up the width there at the bottom. Okay? And just to explain this further, this all together is the width, and this the number 4, since that's all the information we need about this, is the height, all the height. So width times height is the area. The area is 24. The width is b plus 3. The height is 4. There it is. All right, so now looks pretty straightforward, I would say. Avery.
Do 4 times 3.
4 times 3 is 12.
12. And b plus 12.
B plus 12
equals 24.
Equals 24.
Why
not?
It has to be 4 b plus 12.
Why?
You could do 4 times 3 would be 12, and then 4 times b, and it 4.
What's that called?
Distributing.
Distributing. Remember distributing. We're multiplying parentheses by a number. Whether that number is on the right side of the parentheses or the left side of the parentheses, it doesn't matter because parentheses is being multiplied by something. If you multiply parentheses by something, you need to distribute. Okay? We can also see it on this postcard, right? What's the area of this rectangle right here?
12.
What's the area of this rectangle right here?
12. Unknown.
Unknown, but how would I calculate it if I didn't know all? 4 times whatever b is. You see the distributive property right there on that postcard. Yes?
I already solved it. If the area is 24 and the one side equals 12, the b is just 3 again.
Well, let's get practice in solving an equation, okay? Anybody but Robert going to step up today? Jaden and Emma, they've all stepped up.
No.
Oh, Jason.
Then you would minus 12 from both sides of the.
Okay.
And then you would divide by 4 on
yes.
both sides, and you get the equal sign.
We see this form of an equation over and over and over and over. It's like always the last step of solving an equation, right? Unless there's a 1 in front of b, we're always dividing at this stage. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Or the last step, every time it's the last step, divide by whatever b multiplied by b.
Right, how did you get the 4b?
That came from here. You said that the height times the width.
Oh, yeah.
Right? It distributed the 4 to the b you got.
Right.
Okay. Good. Anything else before we take the homework review? What do you think? Is it making more sense?
Yes.
You got two things, basically.
It's two problems.
You basically got two new twists or whatever. I'm just gonna get your desks ready, clear everything away as I'm telling you this. You got two little twists here. Either you're gonna combine like terms before you start, or you're gonna distribute before you start, or you might do a combination of those two things. Here we go. Number one, the first number one. Tiana.
We should combine like terms. 2x and 4x, which equals 6x. There we go. And then after we do that, we put minus 3
very good.
Equals 14.
Uh-huh.
And then we add 3, it's minus 3. Then we add 3 to 14. And then we get 0. And we get 6x and equals 17. And because we're not fractions, we have 6x divided by 6 and 17 divided by 6. And we leave it at that because fractions sometimes can be scary.
Because fractions can be scary?
Yeah, because if you transfer to a decimal, that's scary.
I would leave it. If you divided it, then better be exactly the right decimal. Not rounded. If you don't round your decimal, you have an exactly right answer. If you rounded your decimal, I'm going to take a point off.
Oh, dang
it. Yes, Robert?
What would be the right answer for a decimal?
Well, let's see, 17 divided by 6 would be
2.83.
I'm thinking about it.
2.83.
So it would look like this, 2.83 repeated.
Not repeating.
I wrote rules on the
calculator. I got 2 points.
Don't
just
trust your calculator. Don't just say, oh, calculator, you are so great. You know everything, and I don't know anything. Just look. You got. No, you did it. That wasn't the right answer because you round it at some point to a finite number of threes. This is an infinite number of threes. Okay. If you're going to insist on using decimals when I keep telling you to write it as a fraction, I'm going to mark you off. Round it. Even if you write a million billion threes, I'm going to mark you off. Yes?
You put one and then it's one.
I know. I've addressed that several times.
Oh, why?
Okay. Robert's been doing so much today. He's very tired, people.
I know.
Very tired. Yes, Kate.
You distribute the negative 3 to
right?
2x and negative 5, so it would be a negative 6x minus negative 15.
Minus negative 15. Could I just put plus 15?
Yeah.
Okay. Good.
Yeah. And then you add the plus 2x equals 8. And you combine like terms, which would be negative 4x plus 15.
Negative 6x.
8.
No. 8, not 18.
18. Equals 8, not 18.
Then you would minus 15 on each side of the side.
Negative
7.
Negative
7. And then you would divide by negative 4.
So negative divided by negative, positive.
Dang it!
What's
the
exact?
Give me a break. Just give me 7/4. Okay?
I did this.
Give me 7/4.
Okay, I put negative 7. I just put 7/4, not negative 7/4. I just put 7/4.
It is positive 7/4.
It is? Then why'd you put negative 7/4?
It's a negative. Divided by a negative, this is positive, there's no negative here.
Okay, so I did do it right, okay. So I get 1.
You might have done don't know, added 4x to both sides and subtracted it from both sides?
No, 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 no. I put 7 over 4. So that's the guy. Then I thought it was wrong,
because
you put negative
7
up there.
Because you are subtracting 15 from 8, that's -7. I have taken credit off for answers that are correct, but the work is not correct. Like, the answer is 7/4, but your work says 7 divided by -4. 7 divided by -4 should be -7/4.
Yeah.
Right? So that would be some credit loss there.
That's
it's got to be correct. Well, a little bit. Okay. So, any questions about combining like terms first? Sometimes you combine like terms first, and then you can continue on. And sometimes you what first? Distribute as part of solving your equation, and then maybe you combine like terms. Brandon?
I didn't think negatives cancel each other out, because it's negative four divided by another -4.
-4 divided by -4.
Equals
positive.
Is positive
1.
Oh, okay.
-4 divided by 4 is
-1.
Thank you.
Okay. Well, look at where we are.
Time to leave. We're at the last step of the day.
Yeah.
I think that
here is. I'm going to draw two figures up here. I want you to copy them down on a piece of paper. This is going to be your homework.
We have figures.
Oh, my God. I don't know why erupting into speaking is what you think you ought to do. So our goal here is ultimately to figure out what x is, right? But could you tell me what x is, just from the information I've given you so far?
No.
Good. That's absolutely a great answer. There's no way you could know what x is, right? I have to tell you something more. I have to tell you something about the rectangle. Maybe the area, that would be helpful. Maybe the perimeter, that would be helpful. I'm not going to tell you either one of those things. What I am going to tell you is that if you were to find the area, okay? Let's say I found the area, hypothetically, okay? Say I found the area was 100 what?
Squares.
Very good, 100 squares, okay? And then I found the perimeter, okay? Here's the thing about these rectangles. When I find the area, if it's 100, the perimeter I know is going to be also 100. Just because I said so, okay? Now, I'm not saying that they're both 100. If I just told you that they were 100, then you would be done. You could easily figure out what x was. And they're not 100. The point I'm making is they're both the same number, okay? Because perimeter is measured in like units, right? Like straight lengths, not squares. Okay? So the point here is that the area is equal to the perimeter by number only, not units. Just the numbers are the same number, okay? So the same number of inches around the edge as squares inside of it. Okay? The numbers, I keep saying this over and over because I really want you to not get confused here. The number for the area and the number for the perimeter are the same number.
So
that, given that, you can figure out what x is.
So for B3, there's 100. For B2, so then x
squares 2? No, if there's 100 squares that can fit inside here, then the perimeter is 100. But don't get caught up on what the specific number is. Just knowing that they're the same, you're not going to be able to just say, oh, it must be 50 or 100, okay? So do your best to figure out what x is for both of those. Have a good day, everybody.